Good evening, sir. First for Mr. The PSC Chairman, Mr. Ramirez, can you expound a little on the facility that you want to put up? What will it include? Billeting? As young as how old are we looking at to start training the athletes? And can you give us more specifics about it? How soon do you want it built?
I would look at it and anchor my discussion on the direction of the president that we are setting to a federal government. Mm-hmm. And because of this, the Philippine Sports Commission under the office of the president will be crafting the first Institute of Sports, which is the missing link of Philippine sports. And out of this, it can create a genuine grassroots sports program where we are talking about putting archery in Dumaguete because that is where archery is strong, putting up a training program in Zamboanga because weightlifting is strong, diving here in Panakan, in Davao, then others. So before Christmas, if we are able to put up a Philippine Sports Institute, we are preparing an executive order from the president. Out of that, when the 6 years of President Duterte is gone, we are able to put up a genuine grassroots sports program. That's number one. On Duterte administration. Number two, strengthen the international training. Si Hidilyn is a product of a long journey. Nung dumating siya sa PEC, nobody takes care of her. She was not a part of the team from Zamboanga. So we help her, then we send her to Guangxi training, then competition. So we have the talent, an excellent coach, and international training and breaks on international games. So next year we will have the Southeast Asian Games in Malaysia. In the 18 on 2018 we have Asian Games in Indonesia. Then 2019 we are planning to host the Southeast Asian Game either in Davao, Mindanao or in Manila. 2020 that's the Tokyo Olympics where the target of Hidilyn is gold for President Duterte. So this is the series of activities. So but ang iiwanan ng administration Duterte, totoong grassroots sports program.
Itong group sports, we are at its best with that kind of discipline. Kasi maliliit pa yung mga bata, tapos si kami noon, ginagamit lang namin yung daan. We build a makeshift goal doon somewhere, and dito sa Davao, makita mo, miniligyan ko sila. Pag may kanto dyan, and there's enough space to move around, yan, dyan sila, at right at the start, nagtitraining na ang mga bata eh. They love simply sports. The national sports is actually basketball. Now, individual is very hard because kagaya ng weightlifting, you have to search long and hard. In Manila, if you excel in the universities and colleges, you get noticed immediately. So, dyan ka na, kita itong bata na ito promising because she can jump at a distance. Well, itong mga sa probinsya, we sometimes have overlooked na hindi nakita mga talents natin dyan because the recognition is focused only or most of the time focused dyan sa Manila. So, yan ang tama yan. Ano, we go one for Mindanao and then another one for Negros Oriental Occidental. Dumaguete is in Oriental and vegan. So, doon, ang focusing natin, no need to really stare at Manila because mismo ang eskwelahan nila will take notice of that. At kung rising star ka, you will have the attention maybe and yeah, I mean you get the attention and somebody there would always invite you to enter this kind of discipline and train them. Doon sa probinsya wala tayong not even focusing. Kung meron man yung mga athletic meets sa mga eskwelahan pero it does not provide a good standard because hindi naman natin alam how they were trained and how hard was the rigorous training have been or has been. And I said, makakita pa ba tayo ng iba? and also to equalize the opportunities of the Filipino athletes all over the country. Walang question sa Manila. No need to put up another facility there. The school itself or some people there somehow would get notice of a talent when there is one.
So, sir, this is going to be the job of the LGUs na?
LGUs and the Philippine Sports Commission. They would start to look for ways and they would get the attention of one in any place somehow because this will lalapas ito ng mga meet-meet ng mga athletics. But then again, kung nag-excel siya at one point in his time and there is really no training behind, somehow, hindi kompleto.
The mayor, the president, while he's very generous, he's also very frugal. So what we do now, we are limited income. There are many sports facilities of both government and private. Magmumuha lang kami doon. We'll buy all those materials, collaborate with local government, with DepEd, and put up the training center. So we can have a grassroots sports program. But what is very vital in this grassroots sports program, we will have an institute of sports where it is a source of coaches' education, sports sciences, sports psychology, sports nutrition. Nawala tayo, na naiiwanan na tayo. So, ang tanong, may tanong pa nga. Ang problema doon ng Philippine sports pera, hindi lang, rich or poor country has a problem of money. But if you have a master plan, then from there, you focus on few sports because we have limited income. Then go to the sports where the Filipino will excel, with lifting, boxing, archery, cycling, and others, then there is a big chance of winning in the Olympics. But at any rate, the Constitution of the Philippines cited that it is the duty of the state to focus on the vibrant citizenship so that we can have healthy citizens. From there, we can have formation, discipline, character formation. Bonus na lang yan si Hidilyn. That's why kung wala tayong grassroots sports program, bara-bara lang, wala talaga mga. So we will take advantage of the leadership of President Duterte that on before magpasko, we can have that Institute of Sports. Naiiwanan tayo sa buong Asia eh. Wala tayong eskwela, wala. Kasi look at our boxers, we were very good. Pero somehow, somewhere, nagkukulang yun. And ang prescription ng European sports science. So we are getting Filipinos who excel in Hong Kong na galing Davao sa Pilipinas. Nakaproduce siya, Mr. President, ng gold sa Olympics sa Hong Kong. So kukunin natin siya. Hindi kailangan foreigner eh. We have Filipino sub-talent. I-pull natin yan sa Ultra, rehab the Ultra, rehab the Reserve Memorial, and save those money that we save for Olympic training, international training, buy equipment to put up in the training center. We can have 14 training center all over the country and we have people assigned there, collaborate with local government, magkakaroon, dadami yung talento, dadami yung Hidilyn Diaz. So I'm very confident on this because during our time when I was in Davao City, the president sent me to Australia. When I became chairman, I traveled many countries and went to the institute. So getting all these things, the Philippines will really put up that Institute of Sports. It's not about money. Because if you have a good master plan, the private corporation will help us. And I can see that within these 4 years to 6 years, we'll be leaving a legacy in Philippine sports.